Today, we're going to take a closer look at the 24-inch by 36-inch G0894 CNC router and show you how you can make the most of your router's capabilities. The G0894 features a 3-horsepower spindle motor, and it features stepper-driven ball screws for cutting speeds close to 400 inches per minute. Our project today is transferring a sink template created in CAD for a 30¼-inch by 16 15/16 single well sink to the 110-inch long butcher block countertop with a twist. We'll also be adding drain channels for a drying area directly beside the sink cutout. These drain channels will feature a really cool taper to ensure that the water can flow off easily. For this project, we'll be using 3 bits, a pointed bit which is used to find our origin on the tabletop, a Grizzly H3436 downcutting 1/2-inch router bit, and finally, a 1/2-inch ball end mill for the drain channels. Now, you might be wondering how we can run a workpiece that's 110 inches long on a 24 by 36 inch bed and be able to accurately place the sink cutout. First, our program for the cutout is actually 2 programs, one for the sink itself and the other for the taper drain channels. For each program, there's a user-defined origin to start from, so we start by providing some basic layout marks for alignment once the workpiece is placed on the table. The sink cutout begins at the center of the faucet hole, and the tapered segment begins at the center edge of the sink cutout. With these reference marks placed, we can go ahead and place a spoil board beneath the workpiece. This allows for the cutter to extend just slightly through the workpiece on the final pass and keeps us from ruining the table. On the large end overhanging the table, we've added a roller stand and checked the work surface with the straight edge to ensure there's no bowing. This might seem irrelevant as we're going through the butcher block top completely. However, if a bow is occurring at all, then the cutter, which is perfectly 90 degrees to the table, will have a slight offset, changing the cut angle ever so slightly. To align the workpiece with the cutter, we use a machinist square to ensure it's even along the CNC's table, while also checking to make sure the origin point of the cutout is roughly centered on the table so the machine can complete the full cut. Next, we clamp the workpiece to the table on the corners. There are many ways to clamp the workpiece to the table, including traditional T-slot hold-downs, connecting the workpiece to the spoil board, or a basic clamping like this. With the program inserted into the controller, we first run the test pass to ensure everything is aligning properly without actually touching the workpiece. A CNC router is only as smart as the program you're running. The program we are running today has the X, Y, and Z origins set to the face of the workpiece. So for this, we need to zero out the Z axis location by touching off the tool. So with the cutter touched off, the workpiece positioned and clamped on the table, and the test pass run, it's time to hit go. The machine is running the program in passes assigned in the G-code. This is designed to help minimize tear out on the workpiece and reduce wear on the bit. Once the passes are complete, you're left with a perfectly routed cutout for the sink. We then reset the workpiece, taking into account the drain channel location and ensure everything aligns with the table before clamping it. Touch off the cutter and run a test pass to ensure alignment. Then you're ready to hit go on the matching taper drain channels. Once the passes are complete, you're left with a perfectly routed sink cutout, plus matching taper drain channels. CNC routers like the Grizzly G0894 can be a game changer for anyone from the home hobbyist to the professional woodworker. Adding a degree of programmable accuracy to the building process, that's tough to beat. Check out our lineup of CNC routers, as well as lasers and CNC mills and lathes on grizzly.com.